Ruda will drag your carcass before the Pendragon and let him eat you up.
Yeah. praise to you, wizard.
You will find the Pendragon in the throne room. Don't let his guards give you much pause.
Bye.
So this is the little wizard who has been running through my realm, causing havoc? You have the stink of Mel Ambrose upon you. That is that you have the Sword of Kings. I did not think it possible for it to be raised again. Let us test your mettle against my razor fangs.
Ah, yeah, well, come on. me.
There's a terrible crack, like the sound of the sky breaking, and a twisted crown of wood and thorns falls to the ground. The dragon roars again and starts to shrink and contort. His scales fall away like rain to reveal a broken king beneath.
Greetings, wizard. I see you are a most worthy knight, able to wield the Sword of Kings at least as well as I once did. Thank you for ridding me of that accursed, twisted, horned crown. It is a terrible thing. It has been a long time since I looked out at Avalon with my own eyes. This may be my last hour.
Artorias was transformed by the barbarous horned crown into the Pendragon. Morganth tricked him into donning it after Sir Mallory's betrayal when the king was at his weakest. Artorias is dying, but our work is not yet done. There is still a chance to save Artorias and restore the realm. Go through the door behind the throne. It leads to the Crystal Caves. Do you recall tasting the roots of Mother Oak? We need something even more potent than that. Battle the white and black dragons who chew on the roots and get their venom. That alone may heal Artorias.